talking about probably the most, or one of the most targeted shore species, second to the shad, I'd say, the dusky cop, also known as Daga salmon, yeah, or KZN salmon, salmon, Daga, many different names for them. And in Australia, we're often mentioning Australia, it's just we often get similar species there. They call it a mulloway. The dusky cob, Darosomus japonicus, is a very distinct fish. They've got a beautiful pink sheen to them when you catch them, if they've just come out the water. Tilted at an angle, similar to the bronze ream, how he's got the blue on the head. The cob's got a beautiful pink sheen along his whole body. Big fleshy tail, big heavy-bodied fish. Very large mouth, yellow inside the mouth, not as yellow as a heelback, which is can get quite confusing. But yeah, big large mouth, and they've got these big silver dots that run along their lateral line, which kind of gives you an indication of where they like to feed and how they like to feed. Now, fish use their lateral lines as sort of a sixth sense to be able to feel vibrations in the water. Now, cob is a predator. He especially likes feeding in sort of a dirty water, and ideally in ginger beer water. Not saying the taste, but the actual color of the water is ginger beer. Now, that's that light brown sort of color water, not chocolate. He doesn't like that chocolate water, it gets in his gills, he won't enjoy that. He actually wants to feed in ginger beer colored water, because it disorientates the bait fish. So they don't know where he's coming from, and he doesn't know, or he knows where they are because he can sense with his lateral line. Which also gives you a hint of how to fish for them. Now, because he feeds a lot on sensitivity and feeling vibrations, you know your bait has to have a lot of movement in it. So you'll see when we do make choco baits, any of Ray's choco baits or any of the baits that you've seen other guys making for them, they implement a lot of movement, a lot of noise. So one of the deadliest things is that hollow cell foam with the rattle inside, so it amplifies the noise. And then choco baits with a lot of tentacles on, both facing upwards and down. With that movement, you just attract him a lot quicker, and he comes in for a lot quicker than he would for smell. And that being said, also live bait, because it gives away that distinct vibration of a panicked fish. Now, cob grow very big. It's one of our biggest fish that you're going to be able to catch from the shore. You're looking at a fish that can attain 75 kilograms, and people have caught them up to that size, so it's not a fictitious one day, possibly, they could be that big. But they grow quite slowly, so that 75 kilo cob is going to be close to 50 years, but more likely 40, 45, thereabouts, years old, which is a very, very old fish. When they do get to that size, over about 10 kilos, they're not very nice to eat because their flesh becomes quite coarse and dry. So I'd say any fish bigger than 10 kilos really not worth keeping. They attain about 1.8 meters, so as tall as I am, maybe a little bit less. And yeah, as I said, about 75 kilos. As we said, quite a slow growing fish. The dusky cob, they mature at about a meter, thereabouts, for both the males and females. And that's about a 6 year old individual fish. So it takes quite a long time for them to get to that age. And that's 6 years of angling pressure that they have to be subjected to before they can actually breed. In terms of habitat, that ginger beer water that you're looking for ideally is going to be close to river mouths, and that's where they're going to be most of the time. So anywhere close to that discharge that you get from rivers is often a brownish water that mixes, so it gets that ginger beer color. And then in the bigger estuaries themselves, the juveniles, the smaller cob, they're all going to be in estuaries and around that river mouth area. The bigger cob do tend to travel a little bit further away in terms of spawning and that kind of thing. In terms of times of year, for KZN, it's really more of a winter species, although we do catch a few in summer. We really target them heavily in winter, and that comes down to using choco baits, prawn baits for the smaller guys, live baits is very deadly for them, and fleshy-ish baits, so taking your sardine but with the fillet on the outside, so the meat facing outwards. And then of course on lures, so paddle tails have really, really revolutionized the way we target cob, because you can tell within, say, 10 casts if they're cob in the area or not. And that's because of that thumping of the tail. Down further south, you're looking at, they start becoming more of a summer species. And in the Cape, we get a similar species, but we will do a video on the similarities between the three real major cob species, the silver, square tail, and the dusky cob. So look out for that. In terms of the estuary usage, or when they actually go into the estuaries, August, sort of August to November-ish, that kind of time, is really when the adults are going to go in there and spawn. So when you do catch them at that time in the estuary, please, please let them go. It's much like any of the other fish, when they're spawning, they're quite sensitive to being caught because they're congregated in one area and it's quite a large population in there. And with there being so few pristine estuaries left in South Africa, we actually almost got a handful, if that. If you do get them, they are coming into that estuary to breed. Feel free to catch them, but try and let them go in as best condition as possible. In terms of tack-off when you're targeting cob, it's going to depend on how you're doing it. I like going slightly lighter than most, so I fish my Salters 3 to 5 ounce with a 4500 grinder, and to that I have 20 pound or 30 pound braid depending on the day, and I like fishing my choco baits on that. So that's my general scratching setup, and that's what I'll use to target cob. But if you are going to be throwing a live bait or sliding a live bait, you do need to go up in size. So you're then looking at a 4 to 6 ounce rod, possibly even the 6 to 9, although because of cob, even if he is 50 kilos, he's not the strongest of fighting fish. He's just got mass, very similar to a raggy. Doesn't fight very hard, but he's got this big mass to him. And he does, a distinctive thing with the cob is that it gives you a lot of head shakes as he moves, because he's quite a big, big bodied fish. So yeah, about medium tackle is what we'd recommend for them. 14 foot rod, 6 ounce about there. And then yeah, if you're sliding baits, obviously using a multiplier. And if you're throwing your live bait, then if you're gonna be old school, feel free to use a KP. It's quite a thing to watch. Or using the more modern age grinders. So yeah, lovely species to catch. There are a lot of hot spots for them along the coast. So speak to the local tackle shops, they'll tell you where to go. And yeah. Get out there in winter when there's nothing else biting, go catch some cob. Cheers.